recruit all the soldiers, all the God soldiers. We at war. We at war with society, racism, terrorism, most of them. We at war with ourselves.
God show me a way because the devil trying to break me down. You know what the Midwest is, young, restless.
I wanted to ask you, in Chicago, how did you first get your start in hooking up with Common and getting your start into writing and producing and everything as a whole?
I've been rapping way before I met anybody. I was rapping since third grade, and then like in seventh grade, I started making beats. I really wanted to like just work on video games. So I tried to design the characters and design the movement, and I started to design the music, and it's just like I stopped right there. I was like, oh damn, I really like this aspect of it. And plus I could write rap over these. When I was 14 years old, I went to this music store, and my father used to have me in church. So the best type of keyboard they had there was a Korg. So I just wanted a Korg because it had way more sounds than what I had on the equipment I had at that age. And they was like, well, people that make music, like what you doing, that rap bullshit that you doing, because, you know, like,
at the time,
everybody used to diss rap. That's all it was. Like, get taken, you steal the music. Well, what they do is they sample. I hate it, but they sample. And here goes a sampler right here. And I hit the key, and it played the drums from Summertime by Fresh Prince. And I just started hitting that shit. Drum please. Then it had a scratch sound. It had another sound. And I was like, oh, shit. Okay, I was up there playing. And then we was like, well, how much is it? And he looked at me. He's like, it's $1 million. Well, it was like $2,000. But that was like a Dr. Evil price for me. You know what I'm saying? So then I was in the car with my father riding home. I was like, man, so how are we going to figure out how to get that? I need that so I can be famous. And then so I can follow my dreams and do music, because it's what I really want to do. He don't know what I really want to do, and we weren't balling like that, no way, you know what I'm saying, for up $2,000 or something. And one day I'm skateboarding, next day I'm riding my bike, next day I'm drawing something, next day I'm making some music or writing rap. I had so many different things. How they going to know what to invest in, especially if they ain't balling, where they could just put me into everything I want to do.
Right.
So he's like, man, just save up your allowance. Now, mind you, I'm making $20 a week allowance.
Right.
Well, that's pretty good. But by Wednesday, if I, you know, kept the comic books or whatever I was buying down to a minimal, I'd be broke. So I'm thinking like, damn, I don't know when I'm gonna get this.
Right.
Then I figured out, I was looking, just like studying. I found out that I could get like this little sampler for my computer, like an 8-bit sampler, and it cost like $180. I was like, yeah, I could do it. Beats and such. A blessing for me as an artist, because I charge a fee, whereas I can just do beats every so often and live comfortably, and still the rest of the time, all the rest of my time, think of new raps. I just walk through the house and just think of, man, I'm about to do a chorus like this. My chorus gonna say, well, when you say I'm 100000 up, I got that from Jay Mo Money, Money Anything, and he's talking about he a millionaire. You know what I'm saying? Like, so the chorus is gonna be saying, I'm 100000 old up, hold up, nigga, what? I'm 100000 old up. The zero that made the most zeros, I'm 100000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 such a cliche line, but look what I said. My girl rocking the little lamb that Mary had. Now that's a good line.
Yeah.
I got a little bit of ghosty style, mixed with Moses style. I'm versatile, I'm the poster child. I'm getting cheese, so I'm poster smile. Get it? Yeah. Making hits like Sosa now. Hit it. And I hate when girls be acting bougie as hell, and I already seen them naked like Blue Cane Trail. Fuck is wrong with you, man? You can't tell. I be hanging up them plaques that you can't nail. And just like Nell Carter got a break when Sean Carter took a gamble on me like Mike and Ron Harper at the crap table. But this is the rap table. What you mean you ain't never seen me? You ain't got cable? See? A lot of times people hide behind really complicated words. Like I can do that stuff. Like I did that for mixtapes because that's what people wanted. But I know what the future is, you know what I'm saying? Like, people gave me props for raps that, like Mace said, the things that went 3 mil, I ain't even like. So what I'm trying to do, I feel like the public is that stupid. You try to force feed them what it is you think
that they want.
You know what I'm saying? Just put a throwback on them and a fit at hat and let's get an R&B singer and tell them to rap about guns. And I think it's a lot of people that's tired of that, and it's wonderful for me because now I can have a market for it.
Yo, this is Dirk McGirt. I'm chilling with Kanye West. He's killing y'all.
And I'm off to do that drug dealing just to get by. Stack your money till it gets sky high. To make it past 25, jokes on you, we still alive. Throw your hands up in the sky and say,
I'm trying to give out love, and hopefully you just get that back. You put out that positive energy, and you be a cool person. Just be who you are. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Certain people, I feel sorry for them. They so fucked up, and different things happened to them. They might have been abused, or this happened, or how they've been treated, or whatever they had to go through to be so defensive. And they say they have so many poison inside of them. It's hard for them to just really act right when they're around other people that are just not trying to attack them or trying to, you know what I'm saying? You know, I like when Jay-Z said, show you how to move in a room full of vultures. Isn't that like you don't really have to change who you are and start saying, I'm going to be a snake, I'm going to be that. You know what I'm saying? Just know, you can't let people use you or misuse you. Life is about using people, though. Just don't misuse them. You know what I'm saying? Right now, y'all using me for this. I'm using y'all for the exposure. Mm-hmm. It's working all together. I be sitting up there calling the stations myself because there's nobody. At this point in time right now, nobody is calling radio stations. I'm meeting MDs. I'm promising people, like, yo, I will come to y'all seminars if you want me to help you with your artists, whatever. Mm-hmm. People that can get shit played. Like, I made like enough. I'm like, man, dog, you need help on your album that you about to put out. I'm doing this shit. Ain't nobody saying play Kanye West music except for me and my team.
Wow.
And my true team. I'm talking about John Monopoly, Devon Harris, Don C, Joy IE helping me out now. He the one that gave the record to Flex. He the one that introduced me to K Slay. Like, ain't nobody never brought me to a record label. Ever let me rhyme on it, like, yo, this my man right here, let me do this. You know what I'm saying? So, it's time. I'm going to use the affiliation that I get to be able to get into every door that I can. If people want to talk to me about the beats, give me an opportunity to spit a rap and hope that a few people out there hear it and be like, damn, I like what he rapping about. Dude ain't whack. You know what I'm saying? Maybe I feel what he went through. And, you know, just roll with that.
We right here on In the Street signing off with our artist profile, Kanye West. Look for him through the wire, the single, Revolutionary Artist, Good. That's the name of your company, right?
Yeah, Good.
Good.
Good records, good music.
Good music, just good. It's just good.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all good. And it's good. And in the streets, we're good. You good?
We're good.
Thank you,
ladies and gentlemen, for coming out. God bless you. Good night.
Yo, this is Kanye West, and you're watching In the Streets.